Hi everybody and welcome to this Faceplant review and showcase video. Faceplant is a brand new synthesizer from the Swedish plugin company called KiloHearts. Quick disclaimer here, I did receive the plugin to be able to make this showcase review video, but my thoughts are always my own. With that said, let's take the Faceplant tour. Let's go. Okay, so here's the interface of Faceplant. Let's first listen through some of the presets in the factory bank and then we will go and look at the workflow of the actual synthesizer. Okay, so let's begin by looking at some of the signal generators within Faceplant. You have wavetable, sampler, noise and analog. So let's first look at the wavetable one. Here we have first a sine, which goes from sine into a square wave. So you have 256 frames in this wavetable, which you can animate between. And you can be really creative and go in here and edit your wavetable. You can also do harmonic editing, like you can do in Zebra, for example. You can also load wavetables and convert them from samples and export them. So you have a lot of options there for wavetable editing. So here we have this. Sounds a little bit like an FM sound. So what about adding a filter? But keep in mind, if you add filters in this section, you have to make sure that they are in the correct area here, because you have the signal flow, which is the oscillator here. And you can see by the arrows to the right side here that you have the oscillator going into the filter, and then it goes to the output. And the output, which is an ADSR, sends the signal to lane one. So that's this lane, where we can have the additional effects. So what about modulation? We have two types of modulation in Faceplant. We can add an LFO down here at the bottom side. We have this orange plus and circle, which stands for regular modulation. And we also have this green dot, which stands for audio rate modulation. So that's great if you want to do FM. But we're going to begin with this orange dot, which is regular modulation. So you press the dot and you will see that some of these other orange pluses will appear on your interface. And that's the modulation. So here we can just drag one of these dots and make this LFO as the source and have the target set to cutoff. So it's going to affect the cutoff here. And if you want to change the amount, just hover above the cutoff and this dot will appear, which also shows, you can see that the dot on this LFO will light up to show that they are connected. So I think this is a really great way of showing the source and the target. I really like this kind of modulation because it's very easy to see the relation between the source and the target. And another cool thing with these LFOs, they are not static LFOs. Well, you have the saw, sine, square and triangle LFO. But you can also go in and edit them, so they can be like an MSEG or a multi-envelope generator. So we can go in here and add some dots and create our own LFO, like so. Okay, so let's continue and look at the effects or the snap-ins within Faceplant. Okay, so now you're wondering, what's a snap-in? A snap-in is basically a plugin effect within the plugin. So if I look here in my version of Faceplant, we can see that we have all the snap-ins unlocked. We have the factorator, delays, gates, slice EQ, reverbs, yeah, bit crushers and transgate effects. But if we look at the website, you can see that the basic version of Faceplant offers some of these, the basic kit, the basic snap-ins, a three-band EQ, chorus, delay, gain, limiter, and the stereo effect. But you can also get the starter pack or the professional pack and get access to more of these snap-ins. Okay, so one thing to point out about the snap-ins is that if you buy a preset pack that utilizes some of these snap-ins that you don't have, you can still use them within the preset pack, but the snap-ins will be locked. So if you want to use them within your own sound design and presets, you have to buy the snap-ins, the snaps. Here we can add some delay maybe. Okay, so let's continue and build on this sound. And now maybe we want some kind of transient sound on this because it's a little bit soft in the attack. So we can go in here and also add a sampler. And be sure to drag the sampler up here so it's in the same signal path as the wavetable and filter here. And here we can, it's a regular sampler, so we can add some, maybe a harmonica sound here. Let's go ahead here and add some reverb to this sound. We can add another sampler, drag it up here, and now we will select the sound with a little bit more transient. So maybe that can be a vocal sound. Let's drag down the level for the voice there. So in the sampler you have a lot of options to change the offset. You have looping points like in a regular sampler. Okay, so what about macro and mod wheel control in Faceplant? That's very easy to set up. You can just go up here and hover above one of these macros. You can see that the orange plus, the modulation button, appears. Let's go to the mod wheel here and attach that to the mix of our reverb. So we can introduce more reverb with the mod wheel. So as you can see, you have all these dots which shows the amount and which parameter they are connected to. So as I said before, I really like this modulation setup because we can instantly see the source and target. Okay, so let's finish this off with a bit crusher here at the end of the chain. Okay, so for the conclusion, it's very simple to create complex sounds with the Faceplant. We have all these options for editing our wavetables. And yeah, it's a built-in sampler and we have virtual analog and noise generators and plenty of snap-ins or plugins that we can use to shape and manipulate our sounds. I really like the setup of the modulators because it's often very hard in other plugins to see the relation between the source and the target in our modulation setups. But here it's very easy, just hover above one of these orange dots. And it also shows us by lighting up the actual parameter that is modulated. So basically, this is a really nice synthesizer. I highly recommend this to anyone who wants to learn synthesis. As I've said previously about other synthesizers, which has this module setup, it's very easy to go down and break a sound down because we can just deactivate some of these generators and actually see how the sound is created device by device. So we learn synthesis on the way here. And finally, there's also a little hidden game within Faceplant. If we press this little icon up here, we can play face invaders. Okay, so I really hope that you liked this video on Faceplant. If you have any questions on Faceplant or want me to do another video talking about a certain aspect of the plugin, please shoot me that in the comment section below. If you're new, please subscribe, hit the thumbs up button and the notification bell if you want to receive the news when I have the new videos online. Okay, thanks for watching today and see you in the next video. Bye!